Hotel, then dial your operator.
Have no fear, fellow citizens. The mediator is here.
Good morning and welcome to this week's edition of The Mediator with me, your host, Brian West, here to give you the top eight headlines and developing news stories that have made in this week. Now, as usual, I'll give you the top eight local headlines and developing news stories that have made in first, followed by a movie clip, a skit, a trailer, or something that's going on in the community, or maybe some pictures. And then I'll give you the top eight international headlines and developing news stories that have made in this week. So let's waste no time. Let's get to it. Story number one, are veterans being treated fairly, especially locally? One story about the Blue Coats giveaway sparks some attention on why veterans' issues still need some form of attention, period. Most stories told by veterans usually can only be sympathized or related to in conjunction with other veterans, therefore leaving many veterans boxed in when having to deal with a fast-paced society that many fall behind in. Now, local veterans, like the majority, are still having a hard time finding viable ways to keep up, and many still have grievances. That means they have complaints. One well-known fact is that younger veterans are more prone to not know about or engage in programs put in place for their means of a better transition back into civilian life. So it may be up to you to tell them and keep them informed. It is also a fact that older veterans are more active in nonprofit groups designed to designed and lobbied by veterans' rights groups. So that's also another note. Now, the only way to solve this growing issue, especially the ones that veterans face, is for veterans and civilians to be more informed and active in the political process put in place to improve the transition process. Now, what people don't know and is what keeps the story alive, is what's keeping the story alive, is basically what people don't know. Now, this story points out how more people need to get on the same page when it comes to the future of veteran services. And that's why story number one made it in this week. Story number two, Youngstown plans to retain their planning consultant. Youngstown is looking to hold on to the city's planning consultant for another year with an annual price tag of $75,000. Hunter Morris will be paid $75 an hour. Now, one local article does point out that the company's goals, which are analyzing the city's corridors, housing and parks, they're going to analyze those as well. And McKelvey Lake was also mentioned in the managing plans, along with Western Reserve Transit Authority and other rezoning planning responsibilities were all discussed in this roundtable. Morris will try to achieve these goals by ongoing meetings with the city's design review and planning commission. And story number two, that's why I made it in this week, because it gives us an idea on what Youngstown has plans and how they're planning for the future. Story number three, drugs are still a growing issue for local communities, growing problems. A report from Campbell surfaced about a mother now facing child endangering charges after, she's facing these charges after being found with crack cocaine by the police. Now, according to the local article, her 11-year-old child told the police that his mother was high. The article concludes with the officers finding crack cocaine. And on top of that, the child's father got involved. Now, another report out of Youngstown, adding more talking points to this topic, says that police found 44 pounds of suspected cocaine during a traffic stop on Interstate 76 in Milton Township. Now, other reports of marijuana bust also made some headlines inside of this report. Now, these developing stories add to a growing list of concerns about the issue of drugs in surrounding local communities. Story number three is just another big, big headline that really, really opens our eyes to the reality that we all just don't want to face, and that some people have a hard time getting away and getting off of the drug habit. Keep an eye on story number three. That's why I made it this week. Story number four, local nursing homes still in the COVID-19 adjustment fight. The state number sits at 795 cases in nursing homes this week compared to 992 last week. Now, the number of staff cases sits at 590 compared to 705, and nursing home deaths are still being reported, but those numbers are down also. Most nursing homes have followed the same protocol since the virus first touched down, but many are still adjusting to a number of previous restrictions that have been uplifted. Story number four is just another big headline that really is everybody's been trying to watch, because really a lot of people just want this virus to be over, especially those who are working, going into their 9-to-5 nursing homes job every day, or probably almost every day. So story number four, that's why I made it in this week. Story number five, stray bullets equal continued gun problems. Over the past month or two, stray bullets have been reported in multiple headlines. One report in Warren reported that an evangelist, Ruth Lewis, was hit while at home in her wheelchair. The report goes on to point out that no one knows why the shooter decided to shoot at the house in which Ruth Lewis resided. Now, in the past few months, there have been stories in and out of the news about homes being shot at, some with children inside. Somebody, and that's not good. Now, these incidents are still under investigation, so story number five is still developing. Story number six. Has the city's fire union been treated unfairly? Judge Maureen Sweeney has ruled that the city's firefighters union has been treated unfairly after the elimination of three battalion fire chief positions, according to a local Vindicator article. The article is very detailed about how the elimination of the three positions took place. Now, the article points out that after the city agreed to provide money for some radio upgrades, that it later decided to save money by eliminating three positions, which later resulted in limiting the union to exercise its right to file a grievance, as stated in the article. Now, this thus resulted in Judge Sweeney to rule that the union had been treated unfairly. I hope that makes sense. Now, this story is ongoing because there are still some things that need to be resolved inside of this issue and how the union went about trying to get things done right and take care of its workers. Story number six is why I made it in this week. Story number seven and the top two local headlines in developing news stories that made it in this week. Oh yeah, get to it. You got it. What now after USPS, the United States Postal Service, halted a deal with Lordstown Motors? Developing reports of more setbacks for Lordstown Motors are surfacing after United States Postal Service, USPS, decided to turn down a deal that was worth up to $6 billion. Many now wonder what's next for the electric automaker. Lordstown Motors was hopefully up for a contract with the United States Postal Service, but they decided to do business with a Wisconsin-based manufacturer instead. Now, Democrat Senator Sherrod Brown and Democrat Congressman Tim Ryan wrote President Joe Biden asking him to review the contract because there's some speculation that inappropriate political influence may have been involved in how the contract was awarded to Wisconsin-based Oshkosh Defense. Lordstown Motors does have 100,000 non-binding pre-orders, but was really hoping to obtain a contract with the United States Postal Service to build the company's next generation electric motor vehicles. And on top of that, they wanted to be a big part in seeing this area get more jobs, good paying jobs. That's why story number seven made it in this week. Story number eight and the top local headline and developing news story that made it in this week. Three stories that could impact local residents that you may want to watch out for. It will be very important to focus on how effective the COVID-19 vaccine will be in getting things back to normal. According to a front page Vindicator headline, 1.5 million Ohioans have received the first injection, but the key to this headline will be how effective the vaccine will be in getting students and teachers fully back in the classroom and businesses back at full capacity while also being fully operational with no mask. Now, another story impacting local residents is a new 20-year water contract that Girard just agreed to, which they just agreed to, which will allow water to flow to about 1,500 Liberty residents. Now, the last story to keep an eye on impacting local residents is that Macy's is looking to expand in the local market, adding to a total of 7 companies that will be investing here locally in the local economy. These companies include Lordstown Motors, TJX Home Goods, and Altium Sales LLC. Now, according to the article, this would amount to more than 5,200 potential jobs. Story number 8, that's why I made it to the top this week. Everybody needs jobs to work. Everybody needs work to work. Don't you get that work? Ooh, 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 work. Yeah. Well, those are our top 8 local headlines and developing news stories that made it this week. I'll be right back with the top 8 international headlines and developing news stories. So don't go anywhere. You're in the Mediator with me, Brian West. I'll be right back.
Have no fear, fellow citizens.
If you want to check out the stories that almost made it in or did make it in, go to our Twitter feed on our website. Check out everything. All of the sources are there. It goes to the website. It's METHOD8INC.com. Method88.com, where you can buy something, click on something, watch something, read something, or just sponsor the program.